Hello and welcome back to Let's Play SimCity 4. Yeah, definitely not SimCity 2013. Seems like pretty much almost all the SimCity videos that have come out this week have pertained to that game instead of this one, but it's gonna be a long time before I knuckle under. Well, I could go on ranting about that game for quite a while, but we seem to have completed our loading screen. Let's turn off the night and day cycle first. So, we're back in Gold Heights, and we're about ready to finish the expressway ramps. It's been a pretty dramatic reduction in the number of ramps. Since we started retrofitting this highway, but hopefully we will not get too crippling of traffic problems. It does mean, however, that after we're done with all of the retrofits, it's going to have to be quite a bit of rethinking to do about the network streets. So I'll do that on camera too. Should be interesting. But anyway, we only really have room for one more final ramp interchange. Let's go back here. Doubt too many people will be using this one, but maybe a few people will. Let's try to make these slopes a bit more sensical. Alright, so far so smooth. Just doing a simple diamond interchange. Just like the other ones in the city. And it doesn't like that road being so close. Or it could be another problem too, I guess we'll find out right now. Okay. Wonder why that doesn't run away. Oh, sorry about that. I was trying to press Alt for my street tool, but I accidentally hit the Windows key instead. Very annoying, happens all the time. Hopefully leveling out a little bit of this highway will give us a bit more leeway as far as flattening this tile. Let's re-flatten the edges. Perfect. Go back to our start-end puzzle piece. And it works this time. Great. I fucked that up though. That's just life. Oh, might as well draw the whole thing while I'm here. I think I'll start with the transition pieces for the ramps. The right, the vertical ascension of the ramps. Not making too much sense, sorry about that. Yeah, we want off. Bit too steep to build it right there though. In that case, we do not want the start of this piece. It's not giving us any other though. Jeez. Yeah, hopefully that'll fix everything for us. And hopefully that doesn't introduce any problems with placing the ramp puzzle pieces. Using the wrong transitions, tabbering. All right. Damn. Just doesn't want to work. What, do I gotta place those pieces first? Seems like every day I use RHW I discover new silly sensitivities. But at least it seems like everything... Ah, damn it. Wrong one. There we go. All right. Maybe this doesn't have to be so hard after all. Oh, yes, it does. Well, guess we're gonna have to redo all that. And we'll be moving the side of our ramps. Yeah. A couple tiles should be fine. I think we've got plenty of room there on the right. Do these pieces first again because they seem to be most sensitive. Alright. That was easy. Too easy. It really does feel almost too easy when it just works like that. These parts too. That was also too easy. I think I'm gonna try for onslope here. So. Oh man, wrong direction. I've been meaning to check. Oh, I guess that won't work. Oh, that works that way. Okay, that... doing things like that could make using these ground grazing blocks a lot easier. That's the one we're looking for. Just like that. And like that. Get the overground highway piece in. Just like that. Now just two puzzle pieces left to place. These ones can be a bitch though. If I get it wrong, I have to rebuild everything. Yeah. These are a lot easier to get right than the avenue ones though. Because the yellow lines on the preview are bigger. Alright. That was all fairly easy. You know what? I might as well make that 9W2. Since it is a city connecting road, even though there's nothing on the other side yet. I guess RHW2 doesn't need a connector piece, since it's the default network. Well, man, so that's about all we can fit in on our highway. That was a devastating crash just there as I zoomed in, but I reloaded and I was able to redo everything I'd done pretty fast. I even changed it a bit, put in a little bit of a curve here on the main road. So, with that, it seems like we're done with the ramps on the expressway, so the next part is to fix up the neighborhoods around it that we've made make less sense. So I think we'll start from this direction to that direction. Same as we built the ramps. By the way, I'm not sure if I mentioned this yet, but this expressway through Gold Heights that connects from Mallard Lake to Coconut Creek to Gold Heights on the east, and to the west it goes to some more urban cities, and it connects the regional network. It's actually the first expressway I ever built in this region. And specifically, the area I just did in this episode was the first piece of road that I laid down as a highway in this region, so it's also one of the first to get upgraded. I thought that was a little bit fitting. Anyway, doesn't look like this neighborhood needs too much more. I think I do want to whip out the old MWM for a minute though. Thinking about making an MAV4, same as I used in my uptown neighborhood. Wonder if I could get it through here neat looking. It's worth a try, right? Oh yeah, there's no way though. Never mind, bit of a false start. I just don't have enough tiles for this intersection here to work out. Instead, what might work is to build some kind of transition in this area. This will be the end of the MAV. It's not letting me build it next to the street. Wonder why that is, besides just that it hurts me. I traffic will have the transitions in a couple places. Back to our end wave. Yeah, that's not perfect, but looks up fine enough for me. Next one, I think we'd look at home in this area. Just like that. And lastly, I think we'll have one over next to the spa. Looking good. Making room for a couple starter pieces. A few, actually. You never know how well they'll hold, so you might as well build more, right? That looks correct. And that. And that. Picks right up. As is this one. Ooh, that does not work so well. I don't like that. Looks good enough. Maybe put in another plane tree or two for the ones we deleted? Or instead, a couple big round trees. Add a bit of variety to the airport neighborhood. Entrance to this little office park. And let's finish our end move. Is this really too steep? No, it's because of the transition piece. Oh dear. Well, place it with the scoop already in place. See if that fixes things up. No, won't let me. Too smart for that. Well, I could always try to make this work. And it doesn't. Well, that tower looked a bit dirty anyway. Honestly, I'm kind of glad it ended up extending as far as this ramp. Definitely not a bad thing to have the highest capacity road extend there. Well, that avenue no longer needs to continue so long. I think this area will stay as double wide though, just to retain access to the buildings. This is going to now be our main thoroughfare along this axis. Of course, after meeting that road, we'll have to transition it. And that's all we need to do. Maybe we can have that go something like that. Make this a residential neighborhood. Get a medium density speckled here and there though. For a single family residential neighborhood, I should have been more specific. A little warehouse or something. Just so that all these people don't have to commute crazy massive distances. Yeah, I've still got that cold. Alright. This neighborhood could stand to have some trees as well. Yep. I think that looks all fairly good. A little house at the end of the cul-de-sac. And because this avenue is now a much less important street, I think we can stand to narrow it a little bit. If we can find our main four, that is. Oh, looks like I skipped over it. And again.